Cooking in the Kitchen at Olam's with registered dietitian Molly Morgan, Olam's cooking consultant.
Today I'm in the kitchen with Molly and we're making a sausage and pepper stuffed spaghetti squash. Try saying that 10 times fast.
The tongue twister.
Yeah, it really is. So start us off here, Molly. What do we have?
I've added a tablespoon of olive oil to our skillet. And then we're going to come in, if you want to grab, this is one red bell pepper that I've sliced up thin, and one sweet onion. We're going to add those right to our skillet. We're going to let those start to cook down. And I've got here as well garlic. It's about one teaspoon worth of minced garlic. We're going to let those cook down before we add the sausage. And what I've got here on the tray, this is spaghetti squash that I've roasted. It's still warm to the touch, but you want to let it cool enough so you can touch it and work with it.
Okay.
I did two spaghetti squash, and what you do is you slice them in half the long way, spread a little olive oil, face side down, and then they bake for about 40 to 45 minutes at 350. But how you really know they're done is this. If you take a fork, you can just easily shred your squash. Isn't that cool?
Yeah, and I was telling you I've never made spaghetti squash
before. So flip one over.
Okay.
And then just kind of work from side to side.
Okay.
That'll pull the squash. And you can't really, there's no right or wrong way to do this. And then you want to just leave this in your squash for now. I should also mention, if you've not worked with spaghetti squash before, when you do slice it open, just like when you carve a pumpkin, right?
Okay.
You're also going to have some seeds in there that you just want to scoop out.
This is fun to to carve out too.
Yeah, it's fun to work with. Spaghetti
yes.
squash is so delicious too. It's a really mild flavor squash. See how our skillet's looking. And then we're also going to add some Italian sausage. And I have three patties here, which is just about a pound of Italian sausage. We'll just add, there's little paper separating them in between there. There we go. The other thing, as I know I talk about sometimes on here, I eat mostly vegetarian. So you can use like a plant-based substitute as well. And there's some delicious frozen plant-based sausage substitutes if you rather.
Awesome.
Yeah. We'll just kind of chop the sausage up because we want it to get into little tiny bits. And then we're going to let this continue to cook down. It takes a good 15 minutes for this to really cook down how we want it. So I'm going to actually bring in another pan so we can see what that looks like. And we're going to add our squash to that.
Perfect.
And then, like I said, you want a good... A good 15 minutes, see how caramelized those onions get. Sausages all chopped up. And now we are going to actually just pick up our spaghetti squash and transfer our shreds right into the skillet.
Smelling really good already.
And we're going to save these little shells because we put everything actually right back in. It will still serve as a nice little serving dish.
You just want to stir the spaghetti squash in there?
Stir it in. And
awesome.
Really, as you could tell, our spaghetti squash is already cooked, so we don't really need to cook it down. We really just want it to mix with all of these awesome flavors. And now we want to divide these evenly back into our squash. So I will just...
Hold it steady for you here.
Sure. This is where extra hands in the kitchen come in handy.
Yes. You have your own bowls. You don't even need to...
Yes, it's your serving dish and everything. You can't leave anything behind. Now, set this aside. And one finishing touch.
Some Parmesan.
Actually, shredded cheddar.
Oh, cheddar.
Yes. It's a half cup, and we just want to sprinkle it over the top.
Okay.
And then you can head these back to the oven to cook off again, if you'd like, for... a good 10 minutes to let that cheese melt, or if you just can't stand it, you can just go ahead and dig in like this. Don't those look fun?
They look great. Thank you so much for this spaghetti squash recipe.
You're welcome. For this sausage and peppers stuffed spaghetti squash recipe, visit olams.com. Enjoy the day.
Cooking in the Kitchen was brought to you from the fully operational Thermidor Kitchen at Olam's.